We have already go through the different aspects of market mean according to the syllabus. Now, have you seen my photo?
Your screen, sir. Yes. Yes. We have.
So we are going to discuss today. Earlier we have already yesterday we have go through the different type of process and different type of platform test which are generally conducted at dairy. And what are platform test? Anybody can say? Yesterday I have told you platform test of kya hota hai platform test? The test which is actually conducted on the dairy for quick acceptance or rejections of milk. And a quick acceptance or as a rejections of milk on the platform itself. So we have already covered the different type of test. On the basis of that, we are actually quickly accept or reject the milk. Because there is a very short time, because lot of milk has to be checked. That is why it is comes through the test, through which we can easily reject or accept the milk. And on the basis of that, we can actually accept in the milk. If there is any doubt, we can go for quality control lab and we can tackle it separately. So now comes into the aspect of microbiology of market milk. Have you heard my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So on the basis of you can say that in market milk, you can see the raw milk contains lot of microorganisms. Lot of microorganisms, they may be pathogens, they may be spoilage organisms, they may be different beneficial organisms also, you can say. So there are different type of microorganisms present in the milk. When milk comes from the udder of the healthy cow, milk becomes totally sterile. So when there are so many compounds, we will already teach you in a later class, later topic. There are so many compounds, antimicrobial compounds, which is actually present in the milk. So they are actually protecting the milk to become coagulate. So there are so many compounds. Some name you can say: lactoferrin, lysozyme, lactonin 1, lactonin 2, and they are immunoglobulin. These are the compounds which actually preserve the milk for in summer. You can say the milk not spoil in summer up to without eating up to day to 2 hours, 1.5 to 2 hours. But in cold season, the milk may be stored up to 4 hours without any type of heating. But when milk comes into the category of market milk, that means milk must be pasteurized. Before sending into the market, the milk must be pasteurized. So we are actually categorized the microflora or the bacteria into 4 categories on the basis of temperature. Here we can classify the bacteria on the basis of temperature, because temperature is one of the factor by which we can actually just control the pathogens and growth of other things, so that we can create confidence among the consumer that the product that is milk you can consume is completely safe for consumption. So we are actually we go for pasteurizing the milk. After pasteurizing, there are microflora present in the milk, and there are some bacteria still survive at pasteurization temperature, or even there may be chances of post contamination after pasteurization or during packaging. So there are so many bacteria. We can go through that. There are so many categories. We can categorize the bacteria which can easily on the basis of temperature. Here we are categorizing the bacteria on the basis of temperature. Number one is thermoduric. Thermoduric means the bacteria, the microflora which are actually survive pasteurization temperature. What is the pasteurization temperature? We will teach you in other class, pasteurization in separate class. Pasteurization temperature is either 63 degree centigrade for 30 minutes or 72 degree centigrade for 15 seconds, or any time temperature combination which gives the similar effect. That is, what is the similar effect? That the milk must be free from pathogens. Pathogens means disease producing organism. So what are the thermoduric? Thermoduric are that they are actually survive at pasteurization temperature, and there may be thermoduric, they are actually survive at pasteurization temperature, but beyond pasteurization, they are actually killed. So ye mar jata hai pasteurization se jaise hi upar jata hai. So what are the different type of bacteria? Comes under this category. They are micrococci. Under the micrococci, candidus, leucius, and caseolyticus, these are actually associated generally with the equipment of the dairy. Because milk is handled through different equipment for processing or for separation or for making different type of product, so there may be chances that it is associated with the equipment. Another one, you can say that micrococcus lacticum, Lactococcus liquefaciens, these are the most, one of the most heat resistant non-spore formers. Similarly, you can say Bacillus group mein, Bacillus cereus, Bacillus subtilis, Bacillus circulans, and Bacillus polymyxa. Yeah, these are the organisms, they are comes under the category of aerobic spore formers. Or you can say, in the home, you can say, after taking the milk, healthy milk, just taking, it will not spoil up to 2 hours in summer and up to 4 hours, 3 to 4 hours in winter. But sometimes you can see that when you take the milk and after heating the milk, you can got the milk become coagulate. What is the reason behind that? Because the natural conversion of lactose into lactic acid, when the acidity reaches to the 0.2% lactic acid, and when we heat the milk, then the milk becomes coagulate. But in some cases, without acid production, milk becomes curdled. Without acid production, that means is sweet curdling. What is sweet curdling? Is curdling take place without development of acidity. So how this can take place? Because this bacteria, Bacillus bacteria, they are releasing protease enzyme that actually split the protein casein, and that leads to the defect. So you can see that the curdling due to acid development is different through the with the sweet curdling. So sweet curdling is different and natural curdling is different. So similarly, Streptococcus thermophilus, Streptococcus faecius, and these are other organisms. They are also associated with the pasteurized milk, or you can say with the milk. So lactobacillus is also, so they may actually present after post contamination, or some other bacteria is also present, like Clostridium, Streptomycin, or Acromegalobacter. These may be present in your milk. So what is the significance? What is the significance of these thermoduric organisms? So when we detect these bacteria, you can say that your milk plant is not sanitized. So there is a need of sanitization. There is need of cleaning or sanitization of all the equipment which is used in the dairy. So sanitary condition of equipment, milking equipment, at the same time we can also in sanitary condition of pasteurized plant, because when milk is pasteurized, then the solid particles may accumulate on the surface of heat exchanger, that means or the batch pasteurizer. So that is also creates a problem, and they may be the carrier of some thermoduric organism. So there may be when this is present, then the milk must be repasteurized, because it is not safe for human consumption. So it once again they are back to the pasteurization process. And how we can see significance? Due to the different temperature fluctuations, these organisms produce defects such as sweet curdling, gasiness, proteolysis, and bitterness. So these bacteria is also responsible for sweet curdling, gasiness kis mein? Gasiness, that means when the milk becomes producing some gases due to the release by the microorganisms. So the behavior of that milk is completely different from the healthy milk. Similarly, their proteolysis may take place because when proteolysis take place, then the bitterness may appear in the milk. So sometimes milk become bitter. So these due to this presence of this microorganism, the milk is actually of low quality. Similarly, thermophilic bacteria thermophilic microbial is those bacteria, they actually grow well at pasteurization temperature, either holding or STST. They are actually grow at pasteurization temperature also, and the upper limit of growth is 70 degrees centigrade. So what type of bacteria comes under this category? They may be aerobic or anaerobic spore forming bacteria. Sometimes you can say majority of thermophilic bacteria consisting lactobacillus thermophilus. Lactobacillus thermophilus is also one of the starter cultures that is used for making of different dairy products. But here we can say thermophilic microflora present in the milk. Another species of bacillus like Bacillus stereothermophilus, Bacillus thermoacidulans, and Bacillus caedilactis, and Bacillus coagulans. These are actually also present and comes under the category of thermophilic microflora. Thermophilic bacteria, I have already told you that they are grow well at the pasteurization temperature. What are the sources that their count is less in raw milk? This which significantly increases during holding at high temperature. So we can see that there are the repeated use of improperly clean vats, or residual milk foam, or warm milk in dead ends and vats, or repasteurization of return milk. That means definitely increases the thermoduric count in the market milk. So these things has to be taken care of before sending into the market. Similarly, you can say psychotropic microflora. Psychotropic means cold and loving bacteria. Cold and loving bacteria, they are actually grow at refrigerated temperature, preferably less than 10 degrees centigrade, irrespective of their growth temperature. They may be grow refrigerated temperature, or most of them under this category are mesophilic. Mesophilic means the bacteria which is actually grow at room temperature, or that is generally 25 to 37 for 37 degrees centigrade. So mesophilic, some of them are mesophilic and some are psychotropic. Psychotropic, already told you that cold loving bacteria. They are actually categorized into two categories: psychotropic thermoduric bacteria and psychotropic bacteria. Psychotropic thermoduric bacteria, they are gram positive dots and cocci. You already already studying general microbiology, what is rods and what is cocci, so under this category, Bacillus clostridium and Streptococcus group of bacteria comes under this category. Similarly, psychotropic bacteria under this category, Pseudomonas, they are actually responsible for different type of defect like putrid flavor, like fruity flavor. These are actually comes from milk due to the presence of these psychotropes. Similarly, other psychotropic bacteria, Flavobacterium, Alkaligans, and Acrobacter, and Acinobacter. These are the actually psychotropic bacteria. They are actually comes and grow at room temperature. They are actually survive. So that is why we are telling most of time that under freezing condition, the bacteria remains not die, but they are under the metabolic activity of the bacteria is actually stopped. Due to that, we can actually delay the spoilage of milk. But the concentration may reach after keeping long time under refrigeration. There may still chances of coagulation of milk when the milk comes on the when comes comes into the under the treatment of severe heat. Or we can say pasteurization temperature, or like that. So these are the different importance, and these are the different bacteria: mesophilic, They are comes and they are four categories: thermophilic, thermoduric, psychotropic, and mesophilic. These are the different category of bacteria. They are actually present at different stages according to the temperature and holding time. So these bacteria definitely indicates their presence of hygienic status of the milk plant, and their presence also what is the safety aspect has been taken care of by the respective dairy. These are actually very much important. That is why in each dairy there are several other quality control unit, especially for microbial parts. India is producing number one milk production in the world, but still we are not exporting more than 1% of the total dairy product. What is the reason behind that? Because we are lacking definitely only in the microbial aspect. We cannot actually meet the standard Codex Alimenti Commission that is required for the export of the dairy product to the foreign overseas market. So we are actually far behind the meeting the microbial standard. So that is why we have to improve our collection center. We have to motivate the farmers in that direction so that minimum bacterial load can come from the grassroots level, that is from the village cooperative, so that we can actually provide quality milk to the consumer, and we can also able to export the our product to the overseas market also. Here in India, if the pasteurized milk is having 30,000 CFU per gram, cell forming unit per gram, then milk is allowed to consume in Indian context. Even FSSAI has also allowed this limit. But when we send the milk to the overseas market, then that count must be zero. So you can imagine how the quality microbial quality is different from the Indian standard. Similarly, coliform bacteria, that is actually, what are the different sources of coliform bacteria? They are actually when we pasteurize the milk, they are actually, when they are present in the milk, they are actually destroyed during and definitely if coliform bacteria comes either through any sources, they are definitely destroyed by the pasteurization, or they may also contaminate the milk after pasteurization. If the environment of our plant is not sanitized or sanitary condition is not proper, there may be chances of growth of or presence of coliform bacteria. What are the different coliform bacteria? Escherichia and Enterobacter, Cyanobacter, and these are the bacteria which is actually present, particularly that is coming from unhygienic sources. There may be come from different sources. Even you can get it from soil. If you can be get from cow dung, even you can get it from the fecals. So these are the sources from where this bacteria actually comes. So strict sanitary condition is required. And when we processing the milk in the plant, and after processing the milk, we must definitely follow the guidelines so that our plant is competent enough to produce a safe milk for the human consumption. So definitely we can already know that pathogenic organisms. What are the pathogenic organisms? We are actually already told you that pathogens, they are actually creating disease among after consuming the milk. There may be they are other unlike you can also see that coliform, what are that they are also creating some defects. They are also create droppiness defect in the milk. They are also create gasness defects and unclean and medicinal off flavor and bitterness in the milk. If the milk is infected with the coliform, there may be chances of droppiness defect, gasness defect, unclean defect, or medicinal off flavor defect along with bitterness. So there may be these chances of such type of defect in the milk. So similarly, you can see pathogenic organisms. They are actually already told you they are actually survive at pasteurization. Post-pasteurization contamination, may also also maybe there may be chances of contamination from these sources also. So so we are actually handling the milk what is the we will discuss more in the pasteurization when we teach you pasteurization, then we will be more I will give you more idea about the basis of selection of pasteurization and what how we can check the different type of other pasteurization efficiency of the milk. That means milk is suitable for marketing or not. There are so many these tests we will discuss in that. Similarly, we will have to also study the UHT milk. UHT milk I will discuss their technological part in different way. But here I am just market milk under the market milk. UHT milk is also sold in the market. So we have to also go through the microbial flora, which are actually also present in the milk. In UHT treatment, just you can know that the milk has been given temperature 135 to 150 degree centigrade for 1 to 3 seconds, and depending upon the type of milk. So here we can and they are actually followed by immediate followed by aseptic packaging. That is the beauty of this microflora. So major organism associated with the UHT UHT milk, you can say that Bacillus firmus, Bacillus coagulans and Clostridium species, they are actually associated for spoilage of heat process milk. That is UHT milk, and they are actually in turn either through faulty packaging material, faulty packaging practices. Generally there may be contamination from water or from packaging material or from environment. And what are the index organisms for UHT milk? That is the Staphylococcus, Staphylothermophilus. So these are actually when we take the bacterial aspects of the milk, we can definitely go for testing the bacterial thermophilic count. And through thermophilic count, we can actually assess the presence of the Bacillus Staphylothermophilus in the UHT milk. So you can already know that UHT milk can be not spoil up to 6 months at room temperature. So this is the beauty of this process, that milk is liquid milk is not spoil up to 6 months at room temperature. So so this is the beauty of the processing. So we can even protect the milk up to 6 months after following the just aseptic packaging. So but they are actually add to the cost of the production. That is why that the cost of UHT milk is definitely higher than the polypack milk available in the market. Similarly, you can see the boiled milk. Generally in Indian context, we are generally every household is actually using these practices, that after taking milk from milkman, they are from the dairy which is already pasteurized milk. But still every household of India, in Indian context, they are actually boiling the milk, and after boiling the milk they are actually consuming the milk. So definitely the boiling of milk is definitely the safer practice, because it will definitely kills all the pathogens in the milk. But at the same time, when we boil the milk, because our dairy has already pasteurized the milk, that means there is no need of any boiling of the milk, and so generally we are actually boil the milk, and after boiling the milk, definitely there is some loss of nutrients, because we after boiling the milk or even pasteurizing the milk, some nutrients, some vitamin C, some bacteria, some whey protein are actually denatured. So definitely some nutritional point of view, we are losing some beauty of the nutritive value of the milk. But when safety point of view, that is the good practice of the Indian consumers, that after pasteurize the milk, even after pasteurization of the milk, we can consume the milk after boiling. So have you hear my voice?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Yes sir.
Now Now today this aspect has that microbial aspect of the milk has been covered. Now we can start another topic, but it's showing that only 8 minutes is left. So here we can understand that that microbial aspect of the milk is also very much important, not only the quality of the nutrients available in the milk, but we have to also at the same time we have to focus also on the safety aspect of the milk, safety aspect of the milk. So we can different type of microbial test is actually conducted in the dairy and for checking the milk. So if suppose milk is sent into the market, then we can definitely go for SPC test. SPC test means standard plate count test. Two type of test is actually done generally in dairy, but DMC, direct macroscopic count. Direct macroscopic count is done for there, but they are actually giving both dead cell and live cells also. But in SPC, that is standard plate count, we can know only the live microbes present in the milk. So these are actually present. They are actually assessed in the presence of colony forming unit per gram. Yes, in our legal agency like our FSSI, they are actually recommending if there is a presence of 30,000 CFU, SPC count is 30,000 per gram, then milk is actually recommended are acceptable for consumption. But in the when we send into the overseas market, they are in foreign market, then there must be the bacterial count is least zero per gram. Per gram the bacterial count is zero. So there is a difference in the quality aspects or when we see the availability of milk in foreign market or in Indian market. Similarly, we can go for DMC. DMC definitely DMC, but they are actually we cannot actually find out the actual presence of the viable organism in the milk because it counts also dead cell of the organism. So these are the after that we can also go for there we can already show you that there due to the presence of coliform there is different type of defect, there gasness defect, bitterness, unclean flavor, there are so many defects. So we can definitely go for the PCT test. PCT test means presumptive coliform test. They are actually just giving you the presence indication of the presence of the coliform in your milk. And we can also go for coliform test, but we have to also go for the another 48 hours for knowing the results. So these are the tests by which we can actually assessing the quality aspect of the microbial quality aspect of the milk. But when milk is pasteurized or sent into the market, definitely we can go for phosphatase test. Phosphatase test is actually recommended for checking the efficiency of the pasteurization of the milk. That is, milk is safe or not, that is actually decided by the phosphatase test generally conducted in every dairy before sending into the market for consumption or large consumption of the milk for the urban people. So you can ask any question. If you have any query, you can ask question. Have you any query? Anamika? Rohit?
No, sir.
No, sir. No,
have
sir.
Any query, you can ask a question. Otherwise, today, tomorrow, I will tell you another topic. Tomorrow the class will be from 12:10. That is already scheduled class. And for Thursday, you can ask. You can already told Dr. Bipin ji. So at least Thursday class will be taken care by Dr. Bipin Singh. I will take your class Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.